you. Thank you very much. Thank you, my sweetie. They're obviously selling degrees half price now. Hello, my lovies. How are we? Fine, good. Oh, it's so nice to be here. Thank you so much for having me. I am not like Castor, I must be honest. This little professor is lying. No, because I also feel very sorry for that girl, honestly, you know. I thought maybe we can even release a doll, you know, for Christmas. We can just call it Ken Abby, you know. You want Ken Barbie, Ken Barbie. You know, both of the things. But what can I say? It's very nice to be here because, funnily enough, I nearly did not make it. I was in Durban this morning, had to fly back to Johannesburg, very busy up there at the moment. And I've been staying out in Botha's Hill, you know, but obviously now, of course, it's Botha's Hill. But no, I'm serious. I got so lost trying to get here. You know what? Because trying to get to the airport, because if you come down Botha's Hill now, you know, you get to the bottom, there's that big wide road, it's Manto Chabalala and Sema, you know? You know the one? Yes, that goes nowhere. And I follow Manto Chabalala and Sema, you go past that organic fruit and veg city, you know, they had special, they beetroot half price, and then on the right, on the right-hand side, there's that bottle store, you know, and that's where I went left into Smarts. It's Smarts in Gonyama, sweetie, not young Smarts. Gone are the days, yeah, my sweetie. So I go into Smarts, I follow Smarts in Gonyama, then I go left into Tony. I think it's, yes, left into Tony, not Leon, Yengeni. And I don't know if you know Tony Yengeni, you can't really miss it because there's that lovely big 4x4 dealership, you know, right on the corner. So I follow Yengeni, go through 2 red robots, now I'm already lost, and eventually I see a big road up in the distance, and I'm traveling, and this is Jacob Zuma, you know? So I thought, thank goodness, Zuma, we can't be lost, you know what I'm saying? I arrive at Zuma, I don't know if you know Zuma, I went left, it's a one-way street, you have to go left. No, I'm serious. Have you seen Zuma? Eh? People, it's a long downhill. No, if you win Zuma, you can just freewheel all the way. All the way like that. I get to the bottom, and actually, no, I jumped off the Zuma before he became Robert Mugabe. And anyway, I see Jackie's leg on my left. I skip that, it's too dangerous, it's full of gangsters. Eventually, I take Mandela, Winnie, obviously, not Nelson. And you know, you can't with, because Nelson's the old road. And you go to, I get to the top of Mandela, I see the Zimbabwean embassy, and that was Thabo Mbeki Avenue. And Thabo Mbeki, you know, it changes direction a lot. And then he goes this way, he goes this way, he goes this way, and eventually, Thabo Mbeki turns, and he crosses Zuma. Then turns again and double crosses Zuma. I must say, by the time Mbeki double crosses Zuma, I was completely lost. I can't stick with this road, it becomes more clunky. We all know that's a dead end. So, anyway, I stop, I say, I need directions. Actually, I phoned MTN, but I couldn't get reception. So I pull up next to a car, and I roll down my window, white lady. As I roll down my window, she rolls up hers. Sorry, sweetie. I've lost my love. You know, so, and then eventually I find an Indian man, you know, very sweet man, but he could only give me directions to the mall. Good. And then so I find a white man at last. I said, please, my sweetie, please just show me the way to the airport. And I was there in 5 minutes. These white kids, they know it, but mind you, I should have asked the white in the beginning because let's face it, which middle-aged white South African doesn't know the quickest way out of the country? You know what I'm saying? Anyway, I made it and I'm here.